Now let's go ahead and look at various relations and whether they're functions or not. So the first relation we're going to look at is a set of ordered pairs. So the name of our relation is F, and the relation maps 0 to negative 1, 3 to negative 2, 8 to negative 3, 0 to 1, 3 to 2, and 8 to 2. So think of that as your rule at the end of the day. So then the question is that relation a function? So again, you have to recall the definition of a function, which says that every value of x is mapped to exactly one value of y. So if we go ahead and take the input 0 and we apply this rule for the function, where does 0 get mapped to? What gets spit out? And the answer, if you look at your set, is negative 1 and also 1. So if you think about it, the input 0 got confused on where to go. It, at the end of the day, came out as negative 1 and 1. And in order to be a function, that's not allowed. Only one output could result. And so we would say that this relation is not a function, and our counterexample to it being a function would be the fact that 0 gets mapped to both negative 1 and 1. Sometimes it's helpful, if especially if you're a visual person, is if you take your set of ordered pairs and draw them out as what we call a correspondence diagram. And so I'm going to go ahead and do that here. So I'm going to take all the elements that are in our domain, so all our x values, and I'm going to just, you know, I have them listed here in a circle. So this, so we could see these are pulled from the fact that we have 0, 3, 8, 0, 3, 8. So those are my domain values. Notice I don't list them more than once. I just list each individual value once. And then I would do the same thing for the range values or the y values. And I would take negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, 1, 2, and 2. And again, don't repeat like the two repeats. You don't need to list it twice. And so then what we would do is we would show the mapping of what's going on. And so, for example, 0 is mapped to negative 1. So what I would do is I would start at 0 and I would draw a line over to negative 1, and I'd say that's where it maps. And then I would do the same thing for 3, and I would see that it maps to negative 2. And then I would do the same for 8, it maps to negative 3. And so far, so good as far as our rule as this relation being a function. But then I go and I see that I have 0 also mapped to 1. As soon as this happens, we see that 0 is being mapped to two outputs, which is not allowed for a function. So right away, we can see that this mapping is not a function. So we need not go further. So the relation f is not a function as we've shown by our correspondence diagram. Now, just for the sake of finishing the drawing, notice that 3 was mapped to 2, so that also would be a counterexample to this relation being a function. And then also 8 is mapped to 2, and so 8 is mapped two places also, which again means this relation is not a function.